Thank you so much for being here today. Could you tell us a bit about yourself? Tell us about your current position and your academic background.
Thanks for having me, Crystal. I'm very excited to be doing this with you. My name is Sara Flanagan Martin. I am half Canadian from Vancouver and half Spanish. But I also grew up for many years in the States, in California. I studied integrated engineering at UBC when I was looking for an engineering. I knew I wanted to do engineering. That's the first thing, because I love the analytical mindset, the problem solving, all of this great stuff that you guys all know. And I wanted a big city, so Vancouver was just the perfect fit. And I studied integrated engineering, which when I started, I might get this wrong, but I think maybe it was only 10 years old. It was just getting started. So a pretty new program. I know it's still a pretty new program. But what I loved about it was the multidisciplinary aspect that it has. So within integrated engineering, I combined mechanical and civil, and I tried to focus it on sustainable building sciences and edification. And it was the perfect fit for me. Another thing that I loved about integrated engineering was the entrepreneurial aspect that it has. So that multidisciplinary part and the entrepreneurial part, for me, were two key skills that I wanted to develop, like for later on in my career.
What would be a typical day at work for you as a construction engineer / project manager? I know you have many titles, but if you could tell us a little bit of a typical work day for you.
Well, right now I'm working, after finishing university and graduating from UBC, I moved back to Spain. Because I had done a summer internship at the company where I am now. So I've been at my company for 5 and some years now. And I work for FC Barcelona, which is a football team. But they're doing a stadium renovation project, which is the reason I moved here to do the project. I'm not a huge football fan. I know I'm gonna like get killed by some real football fans. Definitely, like, I didn't play football growing up. I played other sports like water polo, so this was like a whole new world to me. But I loved the project. I fell in love with it. It had all the sustainable kind of aspects that I was looking for, because it was the renovation of an existing building within a super dense urban area. It wasn't like a new rebuild like some of these huge like North American stadiums that are being built now. So fell in love with the project, and it was also an opportunity to move back to Spain. And I started, from the bottom, like doing what a first year engineer will end up doing. You know, I worked with the engineering team on the project, so we're on the client side, reviewing drawings for the building, the mechanical systems, the electrical systems, working under the professional engineers that we have on the team. And it was great. I learned a lot, participated for the first time in, meetings with the engineers, meetings with the architects, and seeing what those kind of dialogues look like. And through those meetings, I kind of realized that maybe I wanted to move away from the technical details. I loved having that background and that knowledge, but where I really wanted to be was more in the decision-making side of things, which kind of pushed me away from being like, 100% technical engineer to more of a project manager position. You know, we've done multiple projects now. We've done a mini stadium, which is a stadium for 6,000 people, which we, together with the architects and the contractors, have designed and constructed now. So I got to see that whole process from start to finish, from the drawings to the construction site, to the negotiation of the contract. So that was a great experience. Then I worked for a little bit as project manager, like junior project manager of an arena project. And now I work as the assistant project manager for the stadium project. So the whole urbanization project is the stadium. It's the biggest stadium in Europe, 99,000 people. And that's what we're working on now. So my day-to-day now has nothing to do with what it was 5 years ago. So no more reviewing drawings, no more taking out like the red marker and talking with the architects. Now it's much more, because also the project is in a different phase, but it's much more negotiating with the contractors, working internally with our corporate services, with legal department, with purchasing department, with compliance department, presenting to boards of directors, trying to get approval. This has kind of naturally migrated me into more of like a business-oriented engineer. So if there are engineers out there that are more interested in this path, I find that the marriage between the business world and the engineering mindset works really, really well. And a lot of people seem to think so as well, because you already have that analytical kind of mindset, but you're just not working so much in the nitty-gritty details, and you're seeing how to apply things together and you know, produce new opportunities, which is really exciting. So yeah, my day-to-day now changes a lot, but it's much more management oriented.
Yeah, I can see why iGen would be a good fit for you, because it has like the business side of things and there's like a technical thing. Yeah, that's definitely a great combination. What are three habits or skills necessary for highly successful engineers?
That's a really great question. I think, you know, if you've made it through engineering undergrad, especially in Canada, it's really tough, you know, because you graduate with this, you know, from a big school where perhaps you're just a number, you're really like fending for yourself. I think that you've already proven once you come out of that, that you're able to analyze big sets of data, reduce them down to patterns and extract conclusions. You know, I think this is already, you know, when you have that integrate, or when you have that engineering on your curriculum, that engineering degree on your curriculum, that's obvious. I think what we don't do super well, and is a really good compliment, is communicating clearly. Right. Because your ideas are only as good as how much the other person understands them, right? You can have the most brilliant idea, but if, you know, the other side isn't getting that value, then, you know, that idea is just gonna stick with you. And sometimes it's a pity that those, you know, that value sometimes is lost. So I think that would be number one, like for engineers, if you know, we can learn even like presentation skills or not being scared to speak up, I think that's super important. My second thing would be to be bold also, because I think at least when I was with a lot of the engineers that I work with, we're more like in the details and analyzing and stuff. And a lot of the times the findings that are so important that those people identify, you know, they don't raise their hand. It's connected to the communication thing as well. So be bold. I would especially encourage women in engineering to be bold. I was in the women in engineering team when I was committee when I was at UBC. I think, yeah, it's super important within a team that all the voices are heard, because each person has their little parcel that they're responsible for, and you're really doing a disservice to your team if you're not raising your hand. And then I think the third thing, and this is just more practical, is to have a healthy lifestyle. So sleep and eat right, and exercise, definitely. Because, you know, I remember those years in university. I remember one year I did 8 classes in one semester because I had my job offer on the table and I like wanted to finish, and that was completely unsustainable. Like I wouldn't want to do that again.
Yeah. You have definitely
been
there.
You're feeling me. I can tell you're like, oh yeah.
Yeah. Could you tell us about your most memorable university experience?
UBC is amazing. It was such a great experience. And it's difficult, it's challenging, but you, of course, really appreciate it when you leave. Related to engineering, integrated engineering, I appreciated so much the capstone project at the end of the year, the like entrepreneurial project. You know, it's the same process almost that I'm doing now in business school. It's curious. Like, wow. In integrated engineering, we had to, you know, identify a market need and then do like a market research and analysis and then come up with a prototype. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I think in the moment I treated it purely as academic. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, this is just a class. I'm going to get it done. I know there's a presentation at the end, but where we're going to present to the industry, but I treated it very academic. Now in business school, we're doing that same process and we're presenting to real investors, and it's the same skills, you know, that they're teaching us now. So I'm very grateful that I got to have that experience, you know, 5-6 years ago. And I think it's super, super relevant, understanding how to look for funds and how to sell mm-hmm. yourself and sell your project and be like, no, this meets a market need and that's why you're interested in it. So that was a takeaway for me.
In one sentence, could you sum up your favorite part about being an engineer?
You know, I still wear my engineering ring. And actually this past week when I was at school, I walked by another guy and I didn't know him at all, mm-hmm. just in the hallway. And he was like, oh my God, you're an engineer from Canada. And he was from Queens.
Wow.
And yeah. And that was the first time it had happened to me since I moved to Barcelona. So I love the community. Mm-hmm. And I think I didn't realize it so much when I was there, but what the community teaches us of integrity, of working for the public good, of doing your job well as you can, mm-hmm. you know? I love that. I love that part about being specifically, a Canadian engineer. I think that's the ethics part of it is emphasized a lot. And I like that.
Well, you gave a lot of good advice and your experience is definitely super, super cool.